I was praying and the Holy Spirit said, my people are dying and that is not my will. My people are perishing because of lack of knowledge. Sickness and disease have gripped their bodies. But I sent my word to let them know that there's healing in my word. So I pray that the power of the living God would move as you listen to this word, that the miracle-working power would flow through your body and through your soul and through your spirit. Acts 10:38 said Jesus went around doing good and healing all, sickness and disease. Psalms 103 said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget not all of his benefits. Who healeth all, did you hear, all our diseases. He heals all our diseases, no matter what the report is. Jesus heals all our diseases. He was wounded for our transgressions, and he was bruised for our iniquity, our bloodline diseases, bloodline curses, bloodline things that's in our bloodline. He was bruised for these iniquities. And the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with those stripes, the 39 stripes that he took, which was 39 of the major diseases that all other diseases stem from, he took the stripes on the cross, not only for our sins, but also for our healing. He never told us that we would not be sick, but he said, I provided healing for those who believe. Exodus says, I am the Lord that healeth thee. Healing means a continuously provisions for us who needs them. I'm reminded of Lydia. The scripture says in Acts 9:32, Lydia was sick and she died. But Peter came, and the woman was weeping over Lydia. And they began to tell Peter how she was such an awesome woman. But Peter kneeled down by the bed. Lydia was dead, but Peter kneeled down and he prayed the prayer of faith. And Lydia awoke and she arised out of her sick bed. Peter said, arise, and she did. That's what a mighty God. I've seen at least three that we prayed for that had died and God raised them up. So this same Jesus who heals is healing right now. Psalms 107 said, he said his word and he healed them and delivered us from all of our destruction. He sent his word. He sent Jesus was the word. And not only did he send Jesus, but he sent the power of his anointing. For this reason, the Son of God was manifested that he would destroy the works of the devil. What is the works of the devil? He comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But my God said, I came to set the captive free. That's emotional healing. To heal those that are wounded. Those are emotional deep wounds of hurt and devastation and disappointment. And those that are bruised, those are times when we have been molested and we have been betrayed and we have been hated for no reason and talked about. It bruises us in our innermost beings, but our Savior came to heal the brokenhearted, those things that have broken our heart. Our children and divorce and disappointment. But Jesus, he had compassion on us. He knew the things that we would go through, and he made provisions for us through his word. His word is alive and his word is powerful. And Jeremiah 3:17 says, I will restore health unto you, and I will heal you of all your wounds, saith the Lord God. Did you hear God say, I will restore health unto you? I know it seems like it's been a long time and it hasn't happened, but if you can embrace this word and to know that it is alive and it's powerful. I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord. Sometimes we say, God, is it your will that I be healed? But I heard him speak in Matthew, the 8th chapter. And the 2nd verse, he said, if you are willing, he said to the leper, he said, Lord, if you are willing, can you make me clean? And Jesus answered back, he said, I will. So it is his will that we be healed. And he sent his word. The word of the Lord says in Mark 11:23, it says, whatsoever you ask in prayer, believe that you receive and you will have it. Too many people have not believed. They believe in their head, but we have to believe in our heart. Our heart is the center of our being. It's our, where our will and our desire and our emotions is. And we've got to, with everything that is within us, Lord, I believe in. And if it's an area in my life, hallelujah, where I'm not believing, help my unbelief. Those areas in my intellect that says, is it possible? Does God really want me healed? But I hear the word of the Lord says, if you believe, all things are possible. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. For they are laws in the spirit. And they are laws in the natural. You know, one of the laws is what goes up must come down. That's a law in the natural. Laws are something that can never change. So in Romans 8:1-2, it says, for the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. So the law of the spirit says, and that's the spirit of the living God, the almighty God, said he has delivered you from the law of sin and death. So even if they've given you a death sentence, there's nothing else we can do, they said to me. But I heard the Lord say, resist the devil. Resist the diagnosis. And hold on to my word. Don't just resist the devil when it comes to sin, but resist the diagnosis. Resist what my body is saying. Resist what my family is saying. And hold on to what God says. The law of the Spirit has delivered me from the law of sin and death. As I declared that word and embraced that word, the spirit of life began